Congratulations for this big achievement.
Thank you, sir.
And getting first rank in IAS means getting gold medal in Olympic. In a country of population of 1,050,000,000, you are in the eyes of everyone. So today the entire country is having an eye on you. And as you are the center of attraction of the country, I want to know that what three basic things, you want to tell to the new coming aspirants that they should always keep those things in mind.
I think this answer. I used to see a lot of topper stocks, and from there I got inspiration as well. So I'd like to point out two, three things. Firstly, if any UPSC aspirant is going through the ups and downs in the journey, then he or she should believe that every other topper, every other who is in the list, has gone through the phases of ups and downs in the preparation. So one has to be cognizant and one has to be confident that if they are going through this phase, then every other people has gone through it. And secondly, sir, I believe that...
Means you want to say that ups and downs are the part of this examination. This should be the first point which should be noted down. Second.
Yes, sir. Definitely it is part of the preparation, and actually it prepares yourself for the examination. You get a lot of maturity out of that.
True.
And success and failures, these are also part of the process. Mm. And second, I believe that you should have a proper plan. In everything, you should have a proper plan. You should have a broad plan, then monthly plan, daily plan. And even if you are able to achieve 60, 70, 80% of that plan, I think that is a success. And you should replan again, and then you should make plan according to your need. So I used to do a lot of these planning and replanning, but my target used to be that I should achieve at least 60 to 70% whatever I have thought. Mm. And third thing is...
Just a minute. Yes. Second point. See, the first ranker says... The gift which you have got from your school, that is diary maintaining, everyday plan.
This is point to be noted.
This is the point to be noted. Diary, maintaining of the diary. Maintaining of the diary is again a major factor. And if you are not able to complete 90%, why you are worried? Even he says 60%. Well, per day plan, per week plan, per month plan, if you are able to complete 60%, you will be here next year. Third point.
In that, I would like to add one thing. Like for daily plan, I used to stick one sticker in front of my table, and I used to write that I will cover these 3-4 things. Mm-hmm. And within that also, I used to dedicate the hours. So my goal was never that I will study for 3-4 hours continuous. My goal was I will study for 45 minutes, then I will take 10 minutes break. Then again I will study for 45 to 15 minutes, then again I will take break. So even if I am able to study 7 to 8 hours that day, I think that on an average is enough.
Well done. Third one?
Third, sir, I believe that UPSC, the syllabus is huge. So it's very important that you should have a very limited... your resources should be very limited. Mm-hmm. And my resources was very limited, and I revised a lot and I practiced a lot, because at the end it's the importance is how well you are able to represent and write in the final exam. That's it. So I think these three things I would like to say.
See, the gentleman says the three things. First thing he says that ups and downs are the part. There is no need to panic. And he used to maintain himself by saying every year, this year I am going to do the best. Means you are your own motivation in this game. Major part of this game. Second thing he says, diary. And third thing he says, revision and practice. So these three things you can consider as the three jewels of civil services. Yeah. Thank you, Mr. Shubham. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. So,